months ago, we stood down on that corner, many of y'all were here, for groundbreaking of the Hugh Howell Marketplace, the Publix and all the amenities and other operators that will take place right around there. And we made a real point, I made a real point of thanking them for their confidence in Tucker, for thanking them for investing in Tucker, for taking all the risks that are attendant to a project like that anyway, but right in the middle of the pandemic. They saw the future, they saw the future in Tucker, and they committed themselves to it. So today, although we've been working on this for a long time, as John mentioned, at least a couple of years, maybe a little bit more than that, but today, Tucker puts its money where its mouth is. They invested in us down there. Today, we invest in the most important, the most critical, the most urgent thing we can invest in, which is our kids, our school system. The people who are going to be 27 in 20 years, they're going to be 30 before we know it, and they're going to be running the city. They're going to be living and praying and playing and working here. And this is what matters. So we sort of leave it up to other cities to engage in partisanship and political posturing and all the rest, bringing national divisive issues right down into our homes and our neighborhoods. And Tucker, we got no quarter for that. We build roads, we help with schools, we pave sidewalks, we acquire parkland and put facilities there that the people of Tucker can enjoy and use, and that raises the quality of our lives. That's what we're about. And so to the extent we're able to avoid all that and focus on this kind of thing, boring as it may be, boring is good. When it produces roads that work, safe passage, all this doesn't just happen. All these engineers who are here, the school system who had to realign their parking lots and everything to make it work, the DOT, they put $500,000 right there in the middle of that road. Wow. Right? Branch Properties not only invested in Tucker in their facility, but they recognize the need for access and safe transportation in and out of these properties. And so it's going to result in interparcel access across here. Thank you, Maurice Moon and his brother Peter, who own Crestpack. We've gotten permission to do that down here. So we're thrilled that there's so many people who've cooperated. The CID has been a great partner in all of this and helping to move it forward and provide some of the resources that we needed to do the planning and to get to this point. So I used the analogy last night of the singer who spent 20 years practicing, singing in nightclubs or on street corners or whatever, and when she burst on the scene, people called her an overnight success. That's a little bit like this project. We got somewhere between 90 and 120 days to transform all this and make it work. It's going to be beautiful, it's going to be safe, it's going to be efficient, it's going to work for the businesses and the school and our neighbors who live down the street that need to get through here. Emily Morseberger and the Tucker Summit CID have been an instrumental partner in all of that. So thanks to all of y'all for being here. I want to call on Emily to say a few words.
Wow, that's a hard act to follow. I want to thank Mayor Frank for being such an incredible partner in the city of Tucker, the Tucker City Council. JDOT, Robert Bram, you are incredible. The school system, our other partners, thank you all for helping to make this happen. I want to call out Larry Kaiser over there. He and I have been working on this for about 9 years and finally have come to fruition thanks to the partnership of everyone involved. We're excited about the improved safety for the kids. We're excited about the improved logistics and movement capability for all of our owners across the street and here. And we're excited about being in Tucker and helping be a good partner with Tucker and the Tucker City Council.
Thank you.
Yeah, of course.